shall reap will we faint not.
Right.
Amen. And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I've been talking about spiritual makeover for the last few weeks, and Tuesday night we dealt with some things on Tuesday night that has blessed us to just see us, because all of us want to be successful in life. All of us need to be successful in life. I think that if we're going to be saved, I believe if we're going to do what the Lord said to do, I believe if the devil is going to be defeated in our lives, we have to desire success.
Amen.
Amen. You should never get to a point in life to where you want or desire to remain the same. I don't think no person ought to remain the same. A lot of times I'm kind of challenged in my message because I'm a practical type, but I believe that people are people. I believe that we have to be true to ourselves, first of all, before we can be true to God and to everybody else. But I also believe that if we're going to do what God said to do, we can't be so spiritual that we miss what God has for us in the physical. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So I was thinking, as God kept giving me these messages, on last Sunday, we dealt with several areas. I talked about consecration on last Sunday, separation, information, saturation, and determination. Amen. Amen. For you that was not here, let me give you that again. Amen. I talked about consecration. I talked about separation, information, saturation, and determination. And I've dealt with this whole week, and I've been talking to people. And a lot of people don't understand the Bible. I think people just been coming to church, but I don't think people really understand the Bible when it comes down to how I should live. If I'm disciplined, and all of us know what discipline is, right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I called it the other day, enforced obedience. Sometimes we have to be pushed to do something. If the policeman was down the street, and I see this so often, they have already stopped the car. The lights are on. You can come down the street. You get your brakes. He's not going to get you back. He's already outside the car.
Right.
But just because he got the blue lights on, we hit brakes.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Well, God desires that same type of discipline. Amen. Because see what he said is, he said, if I can show you a different way, then you ought to respect me enough to just obey what I've said because you desire to be successful in life. Well, if I can see it God's way and understand that this is God's way and what he's done in my life, then the Bible says that I can be successful in where I am. And so in Galatians, it said, and let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap. And a lot of people want to get ahead quick.
Mm-hmm.
They want that microwave type lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Well, how many of y'all believe that all of us have went through a life struggle? Amen. Amen. Even the younger people, being Alicia's age and Ella's age, I mean, all of us have went through life struggles. Sometimes we don't know how to deal with it, but yet we went through life struggles.
Amen.
Well, I was thinking today, since I talked about all that other stuff last Sunday, then you ought to have a celebration. Because if I can celebrate my accomplishments in life, then what actually happens is I can keep moving. I can continue to motivate where I am. I always think about this stuff. I always look at people. And you think about makeover. You think about a woman that has never made up a face, never actually went to the beauty shop, never done this, never put a new dress on, never went to dinner. And then one day somebody gave her an opportunity to go. So she got a new hairdo, she got makeup on, she got a new dress on, she got new shoes on. What she actually wants
and show somebody else what you have.
Amen.
Amen. Now, most men don't have that type of mentality. Of, I got it on. But in essence, a woman want to show that Michael Kors purse or that Coach purse. She want to show somebody, I got it going on.
Amen.
Amen. Then they spend them $400 or $500 for a purse to show somebody I got. And I had one lady, I said, how much money you got in that purse? She said, I don't have any money. Why? Carry the purse. But you.
Amen.
Amen. So we desire celebration. So if I went through life and I allow God to saturate my spirit, motivate my mind, I ought to get to a point where I'm happy about where I am.
That's right.
I'll be glad that God has saw me out and did something in my life.
Amen.
Now, a lot of people always talk about, man, you did this wrong, you did that wrong. Well, the Bible says that if I sin, he's faithful and just to forgive me for all my sins and cleanse me for all my righteousness. I should never walk around and let the devil continue to condemn me for where I am.
Amen.
Or where I have been. I'm celebrating in this sense. That if God is going to do something in my life, if he's going to do something in my life, let us just understand this now. See, this is the part that I can't get. Is that if Jesus died for my sins on Calvary,
uh-huh.
Amen. The Bible said he died for my past, my present, and my future sins.
That's right.
Amen. That's what he died for. He died for my past, my present, and my future sins. My past, my present, and my future sins. Frank, that means he died for stuff I have done that I forgot. He died for stuff that I'm doing right now, and he died for stuff I don't know I'm going to do. Let us not be weary in well doing. I'm going to celebrate this thing. See, what God has done for me, he's changed where I am.
Mm-hmm.
So in essence, I don't even desire to do the stuff I used to do. I'm not saying that we ought to just sin, but I don't even desire to do what I used to do.
Man.
Amen. When God changes us because of the celebration in our life, you know, it's how many of y'all got a job? You ain't got to raise your hand, but
all right.
Most of them got a job. And on Friday or every 2 weeks you get paid, you get a check.
Mm-hmm.
Frank, they reward us for working.
That's right.
That's what they do. They reward us for working. Well, you think about this, that if I work all week and I've saved up money and months have passed, I want to reward myself for doing what I've done.
Uh-huh.
But systematically, I have to do this in a way that I won't hurt something else I'm doing. Amen. You have to reward yourself. That's what my celebration. Because I'm rewarded. It's kind of like a person losing weight.
Uh huh.
Amen. Amen. When you start losing weight, you get on the scale, and wherever you was 200, now you're at 180. Now you can't go and get a gallon of ice cream after you see it. That's not rewarding, that's messing up. But what you do is you see yourself coming out. I want to buy a new dress now. I want to buy a new pair of pants. So I want to get, I'm rewarding myself for losing those 20 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
God said that in everything that you come off of, he said, I'm going to reward you for coming off because you disciplined yourself. I'm consecrating myself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm forgetting those things which are behind me. I'm pressing toward the mark of the high calling of those things that's before me. Well, if I get to this place in my life and I can't reward me for my accomplishments, then I really haven't done anything with what God has done for me.
All right.
Amen. See, what people always do is they show you your sin, but they never show you how to get out of the sin.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. They keep telling you alcohol. How do I'm a drunk? You don't have to tell me that I'm a drunk. I know that every day of the week I drink a fifth of vodka. I know that every day of the week I drink me some cognac. I know every day of the week I smoke me a blunt.
All right.
Amen.
Show me how to get rid of it. Show me how that I can discipline myself. if I never can see a celebration in what I'm doing, if I can never see a reward, where do my goals set up at? If I don't ever, I don't have a destiny of where I'm going. And so if I can't see my destiny, then I can't run harder. If I can't see the finish line, I can't run no harder because I'm trying to win. I'm not trying to compete. I'm just trying to win.
Yes.
That's all I want to do. I want to get to that next place. I want to get to that place because I've been broke. I've been down. I've been to where I didn't know where I was going to get the next meal from. I've been to where the lights was off, the gas was off, the water was off, the phone. They were about to repossess the car. They were about to evict me from the house. I've been there. So now I'm at another place.
All right.
I'm at another place, and maybe you hadn't been there. But my celebration every week is that I put something back because I don't want to go back to that place.
Amen.
I don't need to go back to that place. I want to know that when at the end of the day, I've done something productive. Mm-hmm. How many of you own jobs where your job is not your money? You got a 401k plan, or you got something that your job, you put $20 in, they put $20 in.
All right.
Well, maybe you don't have a job like that, but God got that same command. Amen. God said, you put something in, I'm going to put something in.
Amen.
Amen. I'm self-employed. But, you know, I work for myself. And so whatever I put in, I have to look at it, I put it in. But God said, if you'll put it in a faithful way, He said, I'll add to what you got.
Right.
But if I don't see a celebration, if I don't see a reward in where I am, the Bible says that we have to be found faithful. 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 Ooh. What do faithful mean?
Explain,
bro. Huh? Faithful? What you talking about? Faithful? Man, I believe God. But that's most what people say when they say faith. Because when I believe God, that's not faithful. You don't believe the hell of God. Faithful is following out what you've consented to.
All right.
If you made a commitment to do a thing, I'm faithful and I'm just to do just that. You're not going to change my mind in it.
Amen.
Amen. If I consent to it, you can count on me because that's what I don't care what comes my way. I don't care what dogs fight in. I don't care what wall get up. I'm going to climb some wall. I'm going to get me a flashlight to see through the dogs fight. But I'm going to keep moving. That's my faithfulness.
Amen.
I'm not going to give up because you tried to block my way. And at the end of the day, when it comes out, I'm going to celebrate myself because I won again.
Amen.
But Henry, if I can't see me, celebrate myself. Miss Margaret, I tell most folks, I'm celebrated, I'm not tolerated. Mm-hmm. Amen. You're not going to tolerate me. You don't have to put up with me. Mm-hmm. But you do need to celebrate that I'm in your presence. And it's not that I'm just a good person, but when I'm there, I want you to act like I'm somebody. I got value in my life.
All right.
A lot of folks say, man, I got value. You're not going to put me down here. Amen. 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 This makes sense.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Throughout our lives, and I didn't know how God was going to do this, but He's doing it. Throughout our lives, there is people that have come in our lives to put us down. They've been designated by the devil.
All right.
Regina, they've been designated by the devil to put you down. They've been designated to depress you. And every time you seem like you got a happy day, they show up. Mm-hmm. Oh, God, here they come again. Mm-hmm. They come around and you say, yeah, I lost 20 pounds. Girl, it don't look like you lost 20 pounds.
Hey, man.
You done spent 30 minutes fixing your hair, and she comes around and says, girl, what you doing in your hair? And you said, what you mean? You ain't just on my hair.
Hey, man.
Let me tell you something. You need to start dismissing those folk out of your life. You need to get those folk don't see you having no value. You can't celebrate yourself around folk that don't see no celebration in you. Amen. If a friend is going to be a friend, I don't care what your hair look like, they're going to compliment you for doing better with your something on my face. I told y'all this. Tell me it's on my face.
Amen.
Don't let me walk around with this on my face. Looking like somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Tell me it's on my face. Amen. Tell me that I got a torn spot in the back of my pants that I can't see. If I can't go to the bathroom and I got tissue on my shoe.
Yeah.
Tell me it's on my shoe. Stop it. Stop it before somebody else sees.
All right.
Amen. Now, it might even sound like it don't make sense when it comes down to God, but that's what we miss folk at. Because I can't be so practical that I can't tell you what the wrong stuff on your life.
Man.
I don't want to embarrass them. I'm already embarrassed.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you don't tell me. Amen. But let me tell y'all what stuff do sometimes when people can be celebrated in where you are. Jamal Bryant wrote a book. And Jamal's book was World War Me. And Jamal said in his book, he said, I got some girls. They went out one day, one Saturday, outing. And he took them to the museum, and they had this whole day that they was doing what they were doing. Well, his girls are very meticulous about what they put on and how it looked and different things of that nature. So one of the daughters had a spot that she got on her dress. And she said, Dad, I gotta go home and change my clothes because I can't keep walking around with this spot on me. And he said, baby, you can't go home. We got to finish up this thing. And then we go home. That spot don't mean to me. But she walked around with that spot all day on her dress. When he got home, he let her change her dress. She changed her dress and put it on. But he said, immediately the Lord spoke to him. And he said, a lot of times we have spots in our lives. And sometimes we have to have those spots to show somebody else that we got some failures too. But in the meantime, I can change where I am. In me changing where I am, I can get to the place where God wants me, because sometimes I got to show that I got some failures, I got some faults, I got some misfortunes in my life that I can't do everything just right.
All right.
But the celebrated part of it is that I got God on my side.
Amen.
And no matter how big the spot is, I don't care what sin you've done in your life, no matter how bad it looked like to somebody else, God said, I can take that spot out of your life.
Amen.
You got to celebrate the life that you live in God. You can't keep letting folk put you to a point to where you can never come out of it. Yes, I committed adultery. Okay.
All right.
Somebody know it, Mark. And every time that you come up, it's, man, you remember when you did it? Yeah, I know it. You might be doing something now that you don't know how to get out of it. Don't be weary of well doing, because a new season you shall reap. If you faint not, what you want to come out of? This is the part I'm about to close on. What do you want to come out of? What part do you want to get out of? What part do you see yourself and you keep tumbling and tumbling and tumbling? Keep going back. I know a lot of girls there, they tell you they broke up with this guy. And it seems like they keep going back. What you going back for? I don't know. I just keep going back. The man, he just keep going back. Man, it seems like that woman got a hex on me or something. Just keep going back. They keep going back. What has she got that she keep going? God said, I'll stop you from going back if you can make up your mind that I'm going to do it the right way. How am I going to celebrate me? I'm glad you asked. You got to establish the promise in your life. There's a promise that God made to you. And with the promise that God made to you, you have to make a promise to yourself. That I'm going to do this thing right this time. I'm going to do it right. I'm going to do it right. Something just popped in my spirit. There might be a person in you that has seen your parents do some wrong stuff, or seen somebody else do some wrong stuff, and it caught in your spirit, and you can't change it because you saw it so young in your life. And you keep doing the same thing you saw them doing because you felt like, I know it's wrong, but I just saw them do it. Who's going to break that curse off your life that's on your life right now? It's only God. Once that thing is broken,
God told Isaac this in Genesis 25. He said, I'm going to give you a hundredfold return because you broke the curse off your life. There are some people in here that need a blessing in your life, and the only way you can get it, you got to stop doing some stuff that you don't. Amen. All of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All of us have done something wrong. All of us, I mean, some of you might be doing something wrong now. God don't condemn you for the wrong, but he celebrates you for doing what's right.
Amen.
Amen. He said, this is my child. Y'all remember David? David slept with Bathsheba, got Uriah killed. What did God say? God said, you the apple of my eye. David, I've chosen you. Even when David got ready to die, God had chosen David as king. He chosen David as one of his. But even when David got ready to die, his men knew he loved with it.
Now y'all believe this, y'all believe now.
In the Bible, it said that they brought a young damsel and put it beside him, and David didn't move. They said, the king is dead. Yeah, amen. Amen. They said king because the king liked women. But it never did stop God to celebrate David. I'm saying this to you. If you can get a celebration in your life, stop letting people condemn you.
That's right.
Stop letting people tell you you're nothing. Mm-hmm. All of us have value in our life.
That's right.
All of us gonna do the same thing, but all of us got value in our life. It was so long, I've been preaching 20-something years, and for 12 of those years, I kept telling folks what they wasn't going to do and how they were going to hell. God didn't tell you you were going to hell for sin.
All right.
He told you you were going to hell for rejecting my son. And Frank, I had to realize that because I was killing people, because I didn't tell them what God said. Right. Well, I'm real simple now. I don't get a hoop on, I don't get you excited, because that hoop for me. If I ever get a hoop, that's for me, that ain't for you.
All right.
You got to get to this point. What it said in 2 Chronicles 7:14?